Hello friends, welcome to Hexa Include. In this tutorial video, I will show you how to write user-friendly programs so that user provides input and based on the input, the output will be vary. So let's start it. So first we will write comment program for addition. So now our basic C program structure is complete. We can move on. So here we want to do addition for two different numbers provided by the user. So for that one, we will require three different variables, two for storing two numbers and one for storing the result. For that one, we will declare three variables of type integer. So integer x and comma second variable y and z. So in previous video we had assigned variable x and y value statically. Now we will read value from the user from the keyboard. So for that one, first we have to display message to the user to enter two values. So using printf we will display message to the user. So printf enter value of x. So the first value that will be stored inside the variable x. So as soon as this message displayed to the user, user will enter value for the x from the keyboard. So now we have to store that value. So first value we will store it into variable x. So to scan data from the keyboard, C provides function known as scanf. So we will scan the value from the keyboard. Since user is entering value for x and x is of integer type variable, so for the integer variable we will use %d format specifier, which is used for integer variable, and since it is a single value for variable x, we will use it for ones, %d. So complete single quote, write comma, then use ampersand symbol. It is known as the address of operator. So address of operator, and we will store that value or scan that value into variable x. So here we will write name of the variable x. So it says to the compiler that scan integer value from the keyboard and store it inside the variable x at the address of variable x. Similarly, now we have to display message for another value. So let's say printf again and \n enter value of y. Now you can notice that I have used \n at the beginning of the statement. So what the \n does, it actually starts a new line. That means this message enter value of y will be displayed onto the new line. So whenever you want to start a new line, simply put \n, which is a new line character. So again user will enter value for the y, and we have to scan it by using the scanf. So let's write scanf. Same way, since y is the integer value, we will use format specifier %d and comma and ampersand symbol, and it will store inside the variable y. So we'll write variable name y here. So it tells the compiler to store another value inside the variable y. So now we have both value available, one for x, one for y. So now it's time to add them, and we will store its output inside the variable z. So answer will be stored inside z. So here we will write the equation z is equal to x plus y. So now the x and y will be added and the variable z will hold the result. So finally we will display result to the screen by using printf statement. So write again \n for new line. Display your message, answer is percentage D. Notice that Z is also integer variable, so we are using percentage D specifier, percentage D, comma, and the variable Z, which contains the result. So value of the Z will be replaced to percentage D. Now let's compile the program. One error. So the error says function printf should have a prototype. So let's see. So this line contains error, printf should have prototype. So such kind of error can comes when we have misplaced function name or didn't follow prototype rules for that function. So here we can say printf, actually I have misspelled spelling for the printf. So here print f, and that's it. Let's recompile and run the program. So now it displays message enter value for x. Let me enter from the keyboard 10 for the value x, then I will hit enter. Now it displays second message enter value for y. So I will enter 50 and press enter. So now the answer is 60. So as you can see, 50 plus 10 is equal to 60. So the answer displays 60. Now run the program again and let me enter 10 plus 5, which is the real number. So now you can see our program has terminated. The answer is wrong. So why it happens? So it happens because we have entered a real value while our variable is of type integer. So integer value can hold only whole numbers, it cannot work with the real value. If you need to work with the real value or the fractional value, then you must have to declare variable of type float. So let me modify this program so that we can work with the real value as well. So let me just change the data type from integer to float. So now all three variables are turned to float data type. Second changes that we need to make is inside the scanf first percent scanf function. In place of percentage D, here we will write percentage F. So when you are working with the float variable or the fractional variable, then the specifier will be F, D for decimal or the integer value, and F for float value. Similarly, we have to replace another scanf function, and finally inside printf statement as our z is also of float type. So now recompile, run program. Let me add this time 10 plus 10.5. so now you can see it works perfectly. Enter value for y, let me say 10. So now you can see the answer is in real format, 20.50. so that's it, we can work with the float data type to deal with the real value. You can also format digit to be displayed after the decimal point. By default it displays 6 digit after decimal point. So if you want to display only 2 digits after the point, then we have to format it here. Just simply put decimal point and the number of digit that you wish to display. Let me say I want to display 2 digits, so 0.2f. so if you want to display 3 digit, then put 0.3f. so 0.2 is okay for now. So let's run program. Let me insert 10.25 12. so now you can see output is only restricted to 2 digits after the point decimal value. So this way you can also format float values. So that's it for today. watch my next video for such interesting programs. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.